Yes, 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 yes. So you know how things go. Yesterday I went to, what you call it now? Went to a thing there, what you call it, the Charlotte Queen Show. It was okay. And I like the turnout, good turnout, you know, supporting Caribbean, the island culture. Supporting the Caribbean culture also, the islands, which was good. It was a good turnout and I really, really, you know, can say it was a success. I got some video clippings. It's pretty long. You'll enjoy it. You know, Miss, what's your name? Miss Haiti. She won the competition. So I'm gonna put up this video. It's like probably about it's gonna be an hour and change long, but you can watch it. Now it's gonna be enjoyable.
Eight seven six, a little motivation and inspiration, so you could be a better you. A little motivation and inspiration, so you can make it through.
Right, so we are gonna do a little thing after this. So I said make you see the video after this, so stick around.
Everyone can just slide over a couple of seats so we can actually fill in all of the seats. So back row, there's a lot of space. There's sufficient space in the back. There's an entire row of chairs. So if everyone can actually just shift a couple of seats over where we can actually utilize the last chairs in the final row, that would be great. That would be accommodating for our past contestants. Thank you so much. So everyone here, to my right, the very last row, if you can actually just shift over a couple of seats so we can actually fill in. As more patrons come in, as more attendees come in, we're actually going to have to fill up the last row as well. So you may find yourselves in the back row, just okay. Shifting.
Thank you.
We apologize for any inconvenience.
Your mother
said
she got five.
So yeah, everyone just actually transitioned over a couple of seats.
Tell us to just bring it in.
Yeah, I want this view. I don't want to sit on that view.
I'm sorry, what's the issue? Okay. Well, we actually, if we could just get these four chairs in the back row. So if anyone's sitting in these four chairs.
Everlasting. for hiring and putting her in the building. And last not but least, we have Ms. Joan Francis, also from Dominica. Okay, before we start, I want to know where my audience is from. Anybody's from the Virgin Islands? Okay, represent, represent. What about Jamaica?
Right here.
A lot of clouds. Any Barbados, Bajans?
We got two.
Lucia? What about Grenada? It's sexy body butter. If you want to be slippery, step in the back. And then we have Epic Creation. She does the custom t-shirts, she does cakes, backdrop, anything you want designed, you can go to her and she can make it. We also have our beautiful DJ Spice Traps. Hi, see you, baby. We have our food by Charlotte Caribbean members. We got our salmon balls, balls, ladies, hint, hint, rice and peas, we got chicken, we got fusion salad, potato salad, cabbage, most of it is from, I believe, Jamaica. We have mutton from other islands over here also, so y'all can check them out. The kitchen is here, so y'all can make your orders, okay? We will not let you go hungry, I promise. So now we're gonna tell you guys a little bit about the countries that are representing today. So Cuba is a part of North America, Caribbean Seas. Guyana, South America, their main language is English. And Haiti, that is also from North America, just like Trinidad. And their main language is French and Haitian Creole. So Cuba, Spanish, and Haitian Creole are one of the most spoken languages in the nation. Their food for Cuba is their spices, that's what they are known for. Haiti, their gyro, served with cabbage salad, and Guyana, their pepper pot and cassava bread. So if you ever get to visit these countries, these are some of the meals you can try out. Also, I'm gonna introduce our reigning 2019 queen. Because of the COVID, we're not able to have it in 2020 and 2021. So this is our second annual show. So I'm glad you guys were able to make it. Give you guys a round of applause. So, without further ado, I'm going to introduce our reigning 2019 queen, and her name is Ember from Puerto Rico. She will tell you a little bit about what it is to be a queen.
Hello, beautiful people. How you guys doing? I didn't get to experience the carnival experience after I won because, you know, COVID happened. But I will say I'm very excited to be joining for this year. We have all of our events in June. We have Mr. Killa coming, so it's gonna be like an amazing adventure. So I'm gonna relive what I should have been doing in 2019 for this year. So I am excited to see you guys, to see all the ladies. They have worked really hard. I've seen some of their carnival outfits, and they kind of do their thing. So for everything that they show you on the floor, all I ask is that you always celebrate and clap and holla, hype them up, because it's very nerve-wracking to be on here in front of you. And so just make sure you show love, regardless who you are here for, show love for everybody, okay? Yep. All right, thank you.
to be your queen. Okay, so we're gonna have a dance coming up from the lovely ladies. Are they ready? Okay, let me tell you all something about Island people, okay? Oh, no, you didn't. One thing about us is that we always late. When we come correct, okay? So, just give them a chance, you know? This is our second one, so we're just trying to get everything on track. While we're waiting on them, I'll give you a little background about some of the contestants. Our first contestant, Cuba, her name is Shakila Mays, and she loves makeup. Woo!
Woo-hoo!
I'm not afraid to treating cadets. I'm like, but oh my God, give her another applause, guys. She did a lot of work. I hope you guys taking notes before we're in the dance floor open. I want to see what y'all got. So our next contestant is Haiti, and she is going to do a song for us. So you guys enjoy.
Just in the name, and I'm standing on the front line.
anybody know what is Trinidad and Tobago music? What is it called?
Calypso.
Okay, soca. We all know soca.
And calypso.
Who said that?
Quiet over there.
Yeah, so we are really known for our soca, calypso. We actually have Indian, which is called chutney. Sure. Hopefully the DJ will play a chutney. See if you have any Indians up and up. And what is our Trinidad dish? You see the difference between Trinidad and Jamaica, that's one thing you get a mix up.
Curry,
the roti, yeah. Doubles. Oh, that's me. Yeah. Don't make me hungry. Okay, so we are known for our curry chicken, roti, like you said, double, apple pie.
What's that?
We got some trees high there.
What's that?
Oh yes, the bacon shark is really, really good. And then we have something called a pit shake. And that's one of our main things that when you go as a tourist, you can get to visit the pit shake. That's actually what they used to make the roads.
Asphalt.
Yes. Oh Lord, look at my history, people. Oh my God, I'm gonna be turning that. But what about Jamaica? What is their main dish? Oh yes, ackee and salt, grilled chicken. They do a good breakfast, breakfast also. That's pretty good over there. I love mangoes. That's one of my favorite foods. Oh, we have so much different foods you'll never hear about. We have something called pomerax, pomsite. We got plums, but it's a little different from here. We have governor plum. And even the mangoes, we have a lot of different names. Like we have stash, chewy, rose. So it's crazy how, even though we're here in America, you know, we're so limited to a lot of fruits because of the climate, you know, it can be planted here. But when you all do go abroad, please check out some of the different fruits. Y'all be amazed how wonderful. Even the tangerines, I'll give you a joke, in Trinidad, we call it portica. The avocados, in Trinidad, we call it zapata. Let me say another thing. What's another thing we use? So here, I remember when I came here the first time, and I went to use the bathroom, and I went in the store, and I said, can I use the washroom? And they looked at me like I was retarded. They told I wanted to wash clothes, but it was really the toilet, so it was crazy, a lot of things. I'll give you another joke. When I came here to America, the first place I went was St. Croix, Virgin Islands. That's where my dad is. He plays the steel pan. So, one of the things I had to learn was the drinks, the sodas. So I actually told, I was going to 21, that root beer was liquor. So I saw the kids drinking and I said, Daddy, why are the kids drinking beer? And he was like, there's no liquor in it. Dr. Pepper, I told him, had pepper. So I would never touch it. Yeah, so it was crazy, and one of the things in the Virgin Islands, it was one of the words that I could say is like cheese on bread. That's a big thing over there. Okay, so we're ready now. So we have Miss Diana coming up. So you want to give her a clap, please? Y'all are some newborn, but I have something to tell you guys. So how about we have a carnival right here in Charlotte? So definitely, if you ever been to Caribbean Carnival, we bring it to you. That's how bad.
Oh, man. Sexy Guyana. Oh,
good job.
Look here, ladies. All that beauty. 100% brave. Let's see what y'all got. First, Miss Cuba, come up. We're gonna ask you a question. You get to pick. She's shaking that thing like a tail feather. Okay. Miss Cuba, I wanna ask her own question and ask it, girl.
Hold on. Okay.
Lovely Miss Cuba, pick question number 5. What is the most important issue your generation is facing, and how will you bring attention to it? I repeat it, and I gotta ask Samuel, why are you playing? What is the most important issue your generation is facing, and how will you bring attention to it?
So, I would say the most important issue that we are facing in this generation right now would be the lack of education on credit, whether it's personal credit or whether it's business credit. Why do I say that? Well, I am 30 years old now, and if I would have known at 18 what I know now, then I would be set up for life.
Yep.
And I feel like a way that we can correct that, is by teaching it at a young age, teaching it in kindergarten, starting up. I mean, they're already learning things that they learn in college and elementary school now, so why not learn those things early so we can set our future children up for success?
Beautiful answer, thank you so much. So guys, get your credit. Ladies, kindergarten, starting kids off, okay? Now we have Miss Guyana. Give her a clap. You're making me feel short, girl. I guess they're going in order because her question is number 4. Social media. Don't you love it? If you can meet and have lunch with any person in history, who would it be? I repeat it. Social media. If you can meet and have lunch with any person in history, who would it be? Besides me.
So if I had to meet any person in history and have lunch with them, I would have to say it would have to be Michael Jackson. I love me some Michael Jackson. I might not dance like Michael, but I would dance like Michael. But my reason for that is a lot of people who aren't big fans of Michael don't understand the things that he went through and how he chose to take his life and implement and show different children, you know, even though you grow up the way that I did, you can still have a child. Michael Jackson, as he got older, he still was a child on the inside, and I feel that we're the same. My parents died when I was younger, so I had to grow up a lot faster. Even though I'm 27 now, I still have my inner child that comes out, you know, like I said before, and I really resonate with Michael Jackson. I would love to meet Michael Jackson.
Thank you. Dead man walking, that's what we call it. So Michael, hopefully you'll meet him, not soon, but yeah. We'll pray about it. You're messing me up. Our last contestant, Miss Haley, can you please come up? This ain't funny no more. I'm a tree, really.
Yeah.
Tree, four, five, bro. Nice. I hate to say tree, you get that? Sounds like a mango tree, doesn't it?
Tree.
I gotta work on that.
Tree at them.
Miss Haley, your question is, if you had the opportunity to add a school curriculum, what would you add and why? Again, if you had the opportunity to add a school curriculum, what would you add and why?
So I would actually do financial literacy. That was my answer before. Florida just passed legislation to implement financial literacy into their schools. So hopefully the rest of the country starts to do it. When I was in high school, we actually had financial literacy, we had business law, we had anthropology, sociology, and those things were very, very imperative to the way that we grew up and our financial understanding. I'm a real estate agent, so fortunately, at the age of 23, I became a homeowner, and my parents are multiple-time homeowners as well and investors. So for me, having that understanding at a very young age, understanding credit because of my sister, who helped me understand those things, and just having a background in my high school and understanding to read contracts and different things like that as they are, especially when you get a car. Cars are like the worst thing ever. If you sign the right one, you're great. And if you don't, they're predatory. So of course, just understanding that at a young age, understanding interest rates and how that affects you and credit and paying down loans and bigger deposits, those things have really helped me be successful in life. So for me, I think it's important for us to do those things. I think it's great that Florida started doing that, and hopefully we start implementing that soon in Charlotte.
Beautiful, beautiful meeting. Thank you so much. I want to thank all the ladies, and I love what you said about financial, because the kids are starting to go to work at a younger age now, 14, 15. So the more educated they are to manage your money and not rely on parents will be a great thing. So that's very good. Everybody give the three ladies a hand. Okay, we'd like the three judges to pack up, shut up, and head to the back as they tally up our winner for tonight. While we do that, we're gonna shake again. That's a short version. Miss Guyana, you should have just stayed up here, girl. Judges, they were sweating. I heard one took a drink. I'm not sure which one. But they finally came out with a decision of the Charlotte Caribbean Carnival Queen of 2022, Miss... No, you're wrong. Haiti!